Hello, my name is Toby Ratcliffe-Bothell from TIE's Teaching Institute for Excellence in STEM. Our organization partners with schools and districts to design STEM schools, STEM curriculum, and provide STEM instructional support. We are happy to support the CTE Makeover Challenge. During this webinar, I will share some tips on how to enhance your delivery of CTE and STEM curriculum by integrating a Makerspace experience. Thank you for joining this webinar today. There's a growing body of evidence to show that the infusion of making into a classroom experience is paying big dividends. Making offers the chance to bring a hands-on component to learning. Making can enhance the delivery of a curriculum by bringing a creative design aspect to learning. And making has the power to engage unengaged students. Additionally, we know that making promotes experiential, transdisciplinary learning by engaging students in real-world problem-solving using authentic tools to develop, design, and create. And as we all strive to figure out ways to foster 21st century skills in our students, these skills are fostered as students engage in teamwork, develop creative thought processes, learn persistence when tackling a problem, and hone their problem-solving skills. Teaching math? A makerspace can give students the chance to use math as they design and create something. In the design and building of an object, students also immediately see the impact math has on the success of their project. Throughout the design-build process, students engage in 3D visualization, mathematical modeling, concrete application of mathematics concepts. Although you don't need machines to make, there are some amazing STEM and CTE projects that you can engage your students in when you enter the world of digital fabrication. I will be introducing you to 5 different categories of machines that can be used in your makerspace: 3D printers, laser cutters, electronics workbench, CNC routers, and vinyl cutters. 3D printers are one of the first digital machines that are often purchased for a makerspace. They allow students to design a 3D object using specialized software. Consider brands that are relatively new to the market when you're looking at 3D printers to add to your makerspaces. 3D printers typically range from a low cost of $1,600 upwards to $2,600. Laser cutters enable the precision cutting of paper, wood, acrylic, and fabric. As new desktop models are becoming available, prices of the laser cutters start at $8,000 and range up to $45,000. There's a myriad of electronic equipment and tools that could become part of your makerspace. Soldering and breadboarding skills can be introduced to students, opening the door to the world of microcontroller technology. An electronics workbench can also include sewable circuit equipment, like lily pad Arduinos with conductive E-thread. CNC, or computer-numerically controlled routers, can be used to cut wood, plastics, and some light metal. New desktop and portable CNC machines allow the routers affordable entry into the makerspace world. CNC machines are considered to be 2.5D, halfway between 2D and 3D, because it cannot fully cut around an object, but can create relief work. Another advantage to CNC tools is that they can achieve precise tolerances. Prices for these machines range from $3,000 to entry-level desktop machines to $45,000 to full-capable routers. Our final machine is the vinyl cutter, used to create signs, stickers, or graphics, with a price range from $600 to $7,000. I'd like to introduce you to 4 kinds of making projects. The first is often a personal project, which gives the students experience with a particular machine. The second level of projects is tied to a curriculum theme. It gives students more practice on a machine while reinforcing or demonstrating a STEM concept. In the third level of projects, the engineering design process is interwoven. And that continues to the fourth level of projects, which are usually self-directed and involve multiple machines. These projects could also be a final, year-end, or capstone project, bringing all of the learning together from a particular year into one final design challenge solution. Now that you've been introduced to the value of bringing making into the classroom, as well as the different machines that can be included in a makerspace, I would like to share with you some STEM CTE projects. This is meant to be an overview of examples of projects that can enhance your STEM or CTE curriculum. Detailed instructions for these projects can be obtained by contacting me. The three projects that I will share with you today are the Bridge Truss Project, the Glider Project, and the Vinyl Cutter Circuits Project. Many of you probably have introduced your students to bridge building using a bridge building competition where the strength of the bridge was measured using a bridge composed of truss members, which were made out of popsicle sticks or some other light wood. A CTE teacher in a pre-college program in Ohio has used the laser cutter to fabricate truss members with fastener attachments, as you can see in the diagram shown on this slide. For each of these projects, I will show a set of design and build skills which are introduced, as well as the math and science skills which are introduced and reinforced as the student is engaged in the particular project. For the Bridge Truss Project, students come to understand important concepts such as stress and strain and compression and tension. The second project is the Glider Project. The learning outcomes of this project are mapped to the Project Lead the Way Gateway to Technology Design and Modeling Unit. Three machines are used in this project. A 3D printer is used to create the nose of the plane, a laser cutter is used to fabricate the body and the wings, and the vinyl cutter is used to make the design logo for the plane. Not only does this project enable students to learn design and build skills on multiple machines, but as they iterate on their design to improve its flying range, they are putting their knowledge of math and science concepts, such as the center of gravity, center of mass, potential and kinetic energy, into practice. The final project I will introduce you to is a project which builds on the student's understanding of electronic circuits. Students design and construct circuits using conductive copper tape cut on a vinyl cutter. A basic schematic is shown in this slide. In the first picture, you can see the laser cut lines outlining the tree. In the second picture, the excess copper tape is pulled away, leaving the conductive pathway shown in the third picture. When LED lights are added and the battery is introduced into the circuit, the electronic schematic is transformed into a lit circuit. Series and parallel circuits can also be made with copper conductive tape, as seen in the following pictures and associated Ohm's law formulations. Here's the copper tape analogy of four series circuits. Here's the copper tape analogy for a parallel circuit. Two machines are used for this project, the laser cutter and the vinyl cutter. This activity can also be combined with breadboarding and soldering skills introduced on the electronic workbench. As this webinar comes to a close, I would like to introduce you to three of my favorite books on making. Meaningful Making is actually an ebook which can be downloaded by using the link. The other two books bring two different but complementary perspectives to makerspaces. Thank you for your attention during this webinar. Please contact me if you have any questions about digital fabrication in makerspaces or if you would like to learn more about TIE's Teaching Institute for Excellence in STEM. Thanks again for joining the webinar today.